folks. Mike and Chris Bob both did a great job. And here is the legendary voice of the New York Yankees, John Scott. Hello, John.
You know, we're driving down today. I'm listening to the show. I thought, we have to talk about this. The last time I did your program, and the last time was before Game 5 of the World Series, and you're out in left field, right? When I was there before the game, and what we talked about was how, what is it about the Yankees, where a guy like Pino Martinez made a 2-run home run, the time the game, the Yankees were in extra innings. So they tied it 2 games apiece instead of being down 3-1. None of us could ever imagine that the same thing would happen that night. That was amazing. It's an amazing
thing. It's really
amazing.
And it was a rough
trip.
I mean, for someone that you didn't get to be as upset, one of the both games around, and that day that the bombing of that was a tough day. The next day was it. My next day was even worse. When Mariano actually threw the ball away. But games 4 and 5, never will we ever live long enough to see back-to-back games like that again. And it was incredible. I mean, there was nothing like it. When we got a closest thing in that, you could never leave a ballpark early again. Just think about Scott Brooks. If you ever want to leave a ballpark, think about all the people that did those 2 nights. And we never could have trapped an injury. 20 minutes out there, and then the left field stands. But the same thing would happen to that offense when Yankees go watch that series of
five games. I'll give you tremendous credit, John, because, my guy always wanted to hear the announcers on the teams in the unique situation. Right? When I lost a couple, he always liked to play the ones to see how to come in over. They called the last guy on 2. But we play with John. I got out there. I can run the 2. We play with John, and I can be cool with the Clippy. I came out first, but I did a great call on that. The division was raised 95. And you're cool in game 7 here this past year in November with the Gonzalez pitch at the whole inning. Well, I doubled that on my field line. You were very straightforward with, the best thing they call one of the Yankees. They should be lost. You were very fair about it. You did a tremendous job. You gave up. I was in a plenty of credit. We get lost to win for the week. And I thought it was amazing. The Yankees got the 6 to the bang of a 7 game with a lead. And all you have to do is go back to game 3 in Oakland, or they never would have been there. And why do you feel sorry about it? Very much like Cam Henderson in 86, who could have been the hero. Was a short out. I mean, that's not a big thing. He's a couple of, he's going to be great. But imagine the kid having that big home run in the 8th inning to give him a lead after getting the home run to win against Seattle and getting the
something with that. If you have two lead losses, they work well together. They always took the two roll to the middle one. You know, my timing is too bad, and they work well together. And although that's a little different without doing a game, so it's a little different. So we can both kind of lead the way in different times and different ways. But now you've got two lead guys, you know, both lead guys, both three by play guys. That makes it a difficult deal because Kate came in and the business is a two guy. You know, not a broadcast, he's not a three guy, you know, level one, one guy, he knew that. But he was a good reporter, and he learned his trade, and he's going to get better. But and it fit well with your chemistry, and now you got two dyed-the-wool play-by-play guys working together. That's tough to do. So that's really important. You have to, as you know, you have to listen to each other, you have to respect each other. And I think we're doing that. Charley is very valuable. We have a lot of opinions. And I work, and a lot of guys work this way, but I work with open mics. If you want to contribute, you just jump in. You have to stop at the bench. And Ken, I hear you guys assault people in the province. They know when you hear guys who talk when the play-by-play is not done. Like, well, you think that Jerry guy's great call because that's a great way to spend life. Why would I get a team to get the Alice jump? It's going on all the time. And you hear it.
Thank you.
his games for on radio. Now, part of it's to do 160 games against the NFL. So part of it is to play up games with those guys. Don't let the fact that it is memorable games. But I think there's also a feeling of comfort with John and Kay, and that's broken. So it's really going to be up to you, not so much as for Charley, who works in a live situation. It's kind of you, I would think, if they both been there, the established person, to see if you can make him comfortable, develop a new friendship with him, to be established guys already there. And so a new guy, I would like a mic depth, or I would like a new guy came in to work with them, or I would like a little, to make a mic to bring the new guy in, or me to bring the other guy in. I would think it'd be up to you, since Mike left the coach on him, if you're there, man, you know, that's a good job. And, he's very strong and very knowledgeable and very opinionated, and I think it's a big thing for him. He wants to do a local team, and with radio, I do it every day. You're on 4 hours a day.
I said, you are the radio's personal level one, the audience treats it personal, which is why it's so much fun. And I like to get a response. You're always with everybody. It's like us, they may have us 25 hours a week, I have you 3-4 hours every night. You know, like people that's best. I listen to you, like in the car at night, listen to the game on the way home, and you know, I get a game on the way home, and talk to you guys every day. And boy, I listen to the Yankees over on the weekend, the car, or whatever. So people here, you know, baseball's my other kind of the one sport where you study other sports. Personally, I've always felt they get cheated. If I'm one of them, watching, listening to the radio, after actually watching it, if I'm listening to the radio, I feel like watching it, but I'm listening to baseball and radio, I'm fucking losing anything. I feel like you're being cheated. You can follow baseball so well, or baseball plays the radio so well, much better than the other sports. So it's a piece of it, and you can see if you're being cheated when you're on the radio. I agree too, Charley, in the sports, you know, you really want to see exactly whether the Joe Chuck guy does it more than the, or where the business is a little bit, I guess, you know, I don't know, the front passer. I like you guys from the beginning, when you first come up, you know, well, I came to the Yankees, you know, I'm a lawyer, I'm September 5th, 1989, I thought my nephew was on the Yankees, so I finished in 89, here in January, which I'm not going to get. You were a big fan right from the game, but he's the contract, so I know it's true. He liked this right from the start. I really listened to a lot, and I have to say, he had the chemistry almost right away. And Kay and I did too. I don't think it took Michael and I heard along at all. And I would say that our first game is
how many years you guys have always
had 10
years. I want to talk about your career, including as a legendary player.